Hi, hello. So today we're going to be adding mixed numbers. The very first thing we want to look at is when we are evaluating whether or not we can add, we are looking at these two denominators, 12 and 6. And we know we can't add unless the denominators are the same. So the first step is to find the LCM. A quick way to find the LCM is to list out your denominators, 12 and 6, and then skip count just a few, 12, 24. And I know I don't have to go very far with this one because 6, 12, 18, see, I've already found two that are in common. And here is our least common multiple. And this is very good to find the least common multiple so that your numbers will stay smaller and you won't have to simplify so much at the end. All right. Another tip is when you are writing out this number, you can leave it horizontally. It's totally fine. It's a preference. I prefer to rewrite it going vertically. And I'll show you why in a moment. I'm going to space over a little bit so I'll have a little more room here, and just recopy the problem exactly the same and make sure I have the same operation. This is an addition problem. Now, we know the LCM is 12, so I want to replace the denominators with the number 12. And so when I look at this first one, well, this is already a 12, right? So that's an easy one. And how do I get from a 12 to a 12? Well, it's times 1. Now, I can list this times 1 times 1, but there's really no point. You can just copy this over 1 and 5 twelfths. And you don't have to do anything to this one. But it's different down here because when I'm making an equivalent fraction, I'm thinking each time, well, how am I getting from a 6 to a 12? And 6 times what is 12? So times 2. And remember, when we're making equivalent fractions, anything with the same number on the top as the bottom, this will give us, if you multiply a numerator and a denominator with the same number, then you will get an equivalent fraction. So 6 times 2 is 12. 1 times 2 is 2. Don't forget to carry this whole number on over. All right, so we made equivalent fractions. So we know that 1 and 5 twelfths, this equals 1 and 5 twelfths. It's the same. 4 and 1 sixth equals 4 and 2 twelfths. That's the same as 1 sixth. All right, so now we're ready to work the problem. And you can put your sign again so you won't forget what you're doing here. Now here is your problem. We're finished with this over here. Look at your numerator. 5 plus 2 is 7. The denominator always stays the same. Add the whole numbers. 1 plus 4 is 5. So here is your complete mixed number. 5 and 7 twelfths. All right, let's try another example. Okay, so for our second example, look at the problem, quickly evaluate. Are the denominators the same? No. So let's quickly find the LCM. List out 2 and 5. 2, 4, 6, 8, 10. I could continue a few, but you'll see once you get really good at this that you'll probably in your mind have an idea of what your LCM is. 5, 10, 15, 20. Now, do you see the LCM? Do you see two that match up that are the least common multiples? 10, correct? So our LCM is 10, and that is going to tell us what the denominator will become when we make equivalent fractions. All right, so I'm going to rewrite going vertically. 8 and 1 half. And 6 and 3 fifths. All right, we know the denominator is 10. And we'll just go ahead and put our 10s over to the side. Now in this case, We will see how you get from a 2 to a 10. You're going to multiply times 5 and do the same to the top. And 1 times 5 is 5. Don't forget, bring over the 8. So 1.5 is equivalent to 8 5/10. All right, let's do the bottom part. How do you get from a 5 to a 10? Multiply it times 2. Do the same at the top. 3 times 2 is 6. And bring over the whole number. So 6 3/5 means 6 6/10. Now that my denominators are the same, I can just add. 5 plus 6 is 11. The denominator always stays the same. 8 plus 6 is 14. Now, this is considered an improper fraction, this part here, because the large number's on top, right? So let's leave this over to the side as far as the whole number, and let's just focus on the fraction itself, 11/10. Let's change this part back to a mixed number. 10 will go into 11 one time. There would be 1 left over, and 10 is the denominator. So if I want to add it to the 14, 1, don't forget, the 1, the whole number 1, has to be added to the 14, and that becomes 15 1/10. All right, so here is our final answer. If you use this as your final answer, it's not wrong, but this is the more simplified version. All right, let's see another example. Okay, so our last example, we have a mixed number plus a fraction. Okay, so look at 3 6, and we'll skip count just a few. 3 6 9 12 6 12 18. So look for your least number that is in common. Now, although the 12s are in common, it's not the least number. 6 is your LCM. All right. Now, let's rewrite the problem. 3 2/3 plus 1/6. And we'll make our denominator the same. We want our denominator to be the LCM, which is 6. Notice the 6 is already a 6, right? So we can just say times 1, times 1, times 1, and bring over the 1, and we're finished with this section. How do you get from a 3 to a 6? Times 2, times 2. 2 times 2 is 4. Bring over the whole number. And now we know that 3 2/3 equals 3 4/6, and 1/6 just equals 1/6. All right, now we are adding. Add your numerators. 4 plus 1 is 5. The denominator stays the same. And 3 just plus nothing is 3. All right, so there you have it.